so glad you could make it, boss. Preparations are complete. Everything's running swimmingly.
Darius.
I'm Artemis.
You come to Dracula's parties often?
When he has them.
I am Dracula, god of the night. I'm here to build my nest of vampiruses.
While Dracula builds his nest at the warehouse, the party begins at the mansion.
I have never felt a connection like this, and not in 300 years.
I have live vampirus webcam hacks. Paid online to get access. Think the onstage slaughter interview with the vampire.
You know, line payments are flowing in. We're up to 1,000 pays, $13 a pop. 2,000!
We've got a gold mine.
3,000!
You know Dracula?
Everyone knows Dracula. This is Dracula's party. We're all waiting for Dracula.
I like Nikolai. Because he's boyish.
Meanwhile, one by one, the partygoers are turned into food by the vampires at the mansion.
My neck hurts.
You know, we all have our problems.
Bite every little limb on their body, and we're gonna make them scream like little bitches.
I've been waiting and waiting and waiting for a Dracula.
Van Helsing. I hate that son of a bitch. It's been over 200 years that I've dealt with this guy.
Dracula is actually the one that got away, and recently I was hot on his trail, and I have some information. I know his whereabouts, and I want to end his life.
Dracula!
I am totally a vampire.
Vampiruses are so beautiful. They're like a smorgasbord.
Hi, I'm Dawna Lee Heising, and I'm here with Steve Oakley and Melanie Grunder for More Horror. Okay, well, welcome to the show. We're going to be talking about the upcoming film, Waiting for Dracula.
Well, all the people that love Dracula spend a lot of time waiting for Dracula. You'll find that horror film aficionados, especially vampire lovers, have spent their whole life waiting for Dracula. And in this case, we're bringing Dracula to them in a unique way. It's part comedy. It's extremely dramatic. It has something for everyone, and a lot of things some people can't see. If you're under 17 or 18, you should have two guardians to see this film. It's different. I bring reality television into the mix from my 17 years in reality TV.
Actually, Well, first of all, Melanie, you were in the film, right?
Yes, I was. One of the other actresses dropped out, and I stepped up to the plate and had a ball with it.
That's great. And you're the producers?
Yes.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Along with Dami?
Yes.
Okay, so tell us about your background. How did you get into the business in the first place?
Well, I got into the business because this guy in weightlifting dropped some weights on me and almost killed me, and he said, "I'll make it up to you. Where do you live?" So he picked me up that night in a Porsche, like this, the one James Dean crashed and died.
Is this real?
It's real. And okay. and the reason I got into the business was he picked me up that night in a Porsche full of beer. Now, when you're 17 years old, a Porsche full of beer is a good thing. And it, for those of you who like Colorado beer, I won't name it because we don't have the right to name it, but it's a Colorado beer, and it's quite popular. So we got drunk as a skunk, drove to Beverly Hills. He pulled into the back of a mansion on Whittier Drive, and he said, "I forgot the key. You got to help me break in." So I boosted him up. He climbed in the back door by the kitchen. And there's a little window, and he came around, opened it, and we went into the house. And then there, in the house was the size of a gym field. It was huge, and there was a grand piano, and on the grand piano was a picture of his father, Paul Newman. So the reason I got into the business was because Scott Newman had me help him break into his dad's house.
I didn't know he dropped weights on you, though.
Yeah, he did. That's how we met. And so I got into the business by weights falling on me. And ever since then, I've been after this thing. So I was a young man. Then you start out acting, and then you go into writing. And then finally, when you wake up one day and you realize that you're not the young stud anymore, and you might need Viagra, then it's time to start directing. So that's what I'm doing now. I'm directing this cool play, movie. It's like a play where people had to rehearse their characters and know what they were doing. And
that's right. There was a lot of rehearsal.
Yeah, you have to rehearse. That's the key. Because with dialogue-driven projects, people need to know their lines. And the way we shot this is unique. We shot it with two cameras, with two teams. So it was a very interesting approach. Domi had an entire two-camera crew with a sound guy, and I had the same, and we were running around doing our pieces of the film simultaneously. So most people don't do that, and that's the key to waiting for Dracula. You're going to see things that most people don't do, on screen or off.
Wow. Okay, well, how did you two meet? Now, you were in theater for a while, and you skipped that whole portion.
Well, because I couldn't get a budget for my first film at age 27, I built a theater, and I started NoHo, along with Phoenix Rising Theater. I had the Off-Hollywood Showcase Theater. NoHo is the North Hollywood Theater Arts District. And back in the 70s, we began our thing with a thing called Equity Waiver. And then fast forward, Melanie shows up to be in a play in my theater while I was making a film that was so scary that when the police officers came in the theater one night about 3 a.m. and they smelled a strange smell like a skunk, and we were all drinking and they smelled this smell, they looked around and saw all the paintings of the devil and all these strange murals of dead souls, and they got paranoid and left. Well, about that time, she came into the picture to do a play, and we sort of fell in love quickly.
He gave me the lead role.
Okay, great.
Lead role. She had a wig so she could play two characters. So fast forward, we've made this movie, and we want people to see it. It should change the way people think about horror films. It's taking what they are used to in reality television, and it's blending it with what they're used to in horror films.
Yeah, and I was there for the second part of the shoot, and it was a gorgeous house, and Domi did take the whole top, and Steve was on the bottom, and it was, and there was a cast of thousands, really, in this movie.
We worked very hard to make this happen, and the key to it is you, the audience, want to find out what waiting for Dracula means. It's existential. It's like waiting for Godot. It's the same kind of thing. And yes, there is nudity. And yes, there are some things that only hip people will enjoy, and that's why you want to see it.
Well, it wouldn't be a Steve Oakley film if there weren't nudity in there.
Okay. Well, tell us the story.
Okay, waiting for Dracula. Simple story. Dracula is running out of money. What are you going to do? Even Dracula is broke in this depression. So he whips up a great idea along with Renfield, which is Domiziano Arcangeli's role. He really does a knockdown, drag-out job of doing this Renfield in a way that's never been done before. It's funny and it's dramatic. And the new game is that they have to make money. Webisodes are the way to make money. So they utilize the technique that was the best thing in the Dracula movie, where all in France, all of the vampires were eating the little live people naked on stage, in Interview with a Vampire. They take this gag and they put it into a webisode. And naturally, wouldn't you pay $13 to watch a naked woman get killed and turn into a vampirus? I mean, that's the premise of the movie. Wouldn't you pay $13 to own Waiting for Dracula?
Okay, so when will it be done?
We're in the final phase of editing, and then it goes off to composing. And a unique thought for filmmakers, for directors. Usually composers compose a whole film. Ah! Au contraire, you really need to just have one scene at a time where the music is added. That way you can determine exactly where you're at all times with each scene. It just came to me last night because I've been working on a project. This is a very important discovery.
Wow, okay, now what's the website?
The website is going to be GrunderOakleyProductions.com.
Yep.
And it's your production company.
Yes, and you can also find out about it on TheEmpireFilms.com. It's a co-production. Grunder Oakley Films and Empire Films will bring you Waiting for Dracula.
Wow, it sounds so exciting. I can't wait. And the poster is done, and it's on IMDb.
The first poster, we're going to have dozens. And if you have any ideas, you know, send us your ideas. We might even do your poster.
Okay, thanks, Steve. Thanks, Melanie. And we can't wait till the film's out.
Neither can I. Can't wait. You can get it at empirefilms.net.